On today's episode on WarpDriveM, we are going to tear apart this V8 in order to find out what the heck is wrong with this one. Before we start tearing apart this engine, this is a BMW N62 engine, this is a V8. This has a few variants like 3.6 liters, 4.4 liters and so on, but this one is a 3.6 liter engine. This came out from a BMW E65 735i. Basically, this engine was mixing oil with water. And now we are going to try to figure out from where. From the start, we can see that we have a JB weld in here where the timing chain is, and maybe somebody drilled in here till the other side and destroyed the engine block. We are going to find that out and check this out. Check this out. A complete engine should look like this, with the intake, and after you remove the intake, you will have something like this. Underneath the intake, you will have the cross pipe from the water pump that goes all the way back to the engine and is going to cool this side of the engine block. We are going to remove this flywheel and you are going to see the water channels in there. And in here, on these four holes, you will have the knock sensor. Two knock sensor on each bank. Top of the engine, you will have the Veltronic motors that are bolted on this adapter plate. You take the Veltronic motors first out, you are going to take the adapter plate, and after that we can remove the engine cover. On each valve cover, you will have these caps in here that are the PCV valves. You can remove those, and these are the membrane. You have to check those for cracks if you have a bad idle, but this one looks decent except for the milkshake from the oil and water mixture. Okay, we can take this out, the same milkshake in there. And in order to remove the valve cover, we have to unbolt all the nuts and bolts. You will have the intake and the exhaust camshaft. You will have the sensor in here, take those out. And in here you have the eccentric shaft. On this bank I don't have that, but you can see that in here. Take this plate out with the gasket, and this is the eccentric shaft, is bolted directly on the cam. To make the removal easier, we are going to take the bracket for the engine out. You will have two 13 millimeter bolts. The second one. We are going to remove this bracket as well for the wiring harness. This is the back of the engine. These are two 10 millimeter screws. And now we can move to all the nuts and bolts. 10 millimeters everywhere. This one is out. This one is out as well. With a T25, you can remove the adapter plate for the Veltronic motors. With a 10 millimeter socket, we are going to remove the cover from the cross pipe. And surprise, surprise, we don't have a mixture in here. So apparently the water is going directly into the oil pan. And it might be just this cover in here where the timing chain is, and somewhere in here is going to mix. Because in the water we don't have any oil, we have water in oil. Now with 10 millimeter socket, we are going to remove the whole cover. The other side now. The timing chain and the guides looks decent, are not new but are decent. Okay, we have water in here, see that? Oops. Now maybe you can see how the water is coming out. Okay, the guide in here looks decent as well. We can take the tensioner out in here, 27, 24, the oil sander unit. In order to remove this cover, we have to start by removing these two bolts. These are E12, but in order to remove this one on both sides, we have to take the chain and the Venus unit out in the camshaft, because you cannot see that this is, you cannot remove it with a normal socket because there is no place to put the socket in there. This one, no problem. Oops, it's working. Yeah. Okay. But this one we cannot. So that's why we have to remove the Venus first. Let's try this one as well. Oh, this one is loose. Okay, and the same problem in here. Perfect. Now we are going to disassemble the Venus unit. We are going to take the camshaft from here, and after that we can take these two out, the chain, the guides, and everything here in the front. With a 13 millimeter socket, we are going to remove the oil pipe. With a 10 millimeter, we are going to remove the bracket for the guide. With a 16 millimeter socket, we are going to remove the Venus from the camshaft. And now with the E12, we can remove this bolt. And we are going to repeat the process on this side. In order to remove the head now, we are almost there, but we have to remove the intake cam because we have some bolts in there and right up in there. We can leave the exhaust cam in here, but we have to remove the intake cam. All around 10 millimeters socket. have to untension the spring with a T45. Now basically we can remove this. This is the spring. Now we have access to all the bolts. With E12 now, we are going to remove all the head bolts. Now with the head off, we can see that we don't have any kind of head gasket problem, because everything, the head gasket is fine. There is no burn marks, or there is no water marks. And as you can see here, this water is here because I removed the head and the water channel was filling the cylinder walls. But as you can see, the water is in here, so it's not going to into the oil pan. That means the cylinders and the rings are okay. So now we are going to remove the other side, and after that we are going to take the cover out, because I'm pretty sure the problem is in here somewhere. And we might end up the video in here, because I have some problems with this bolt, the crank bolt. I cannot take this out. I locked in here the engine, as you can see. I've used this is a tool for clutch, but it's locked, it cannot rotate anymore. But I've used this pry bar, this one, the big gun, and it's not budging at all. So till the next episode, I'm going to try to take this off camera, and we are going to continue after that in the next episode. We have a lot of parts in here: engine cover, we have the Venus, we have the intake camshaft, we have the heads in here, head gasket in here, the covers, the flywheel. We took almost everything out, but I cannot take this cover in order to reach the other stuff behind this one, because I want to see if our problem is in here. And I can see something, that the gasket is destroyed in there. See that? This gasket is completely destroyed, and I think the water was coming in here. So maybe we can put this back together, but first I have to take this bolt out, and for now it doesn't move at all. I'm going to use some fire, some, I'm not really sure what, but we are going to do that in the next episode. So join me for the next episode to see more progress on this engine. If you like this episode, please give me a thumbs up. If you don't like the video, as usual, thumbs down. Until next time, see you later.